This tutorial shows how to extract pages from PDFs in Adobe Acrobat. Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows two ways to extract pages from PDFs in Adobe Acrobat. First, we'll look at how to use Acrobat's extract tool. Then we'll use the drag and drop method. We'll walk through the steps to split a PDF into smaller PDFs in a separate tutorial. I'll be using Adobe Acrobat DC. These steps also apply to Adobe Acrobat 2020 and Adobe Acrobat 2017. In addition, the steps are similar for PC and Mac users. The few differences between the two systems will be explained within the individual steps. Adobe's free PDF display software, Acrobat Reader, doesn't offer page extraction options. It's important to note that these steps won't work if the original PDF has security restrictions preventing extraction. To use the extract tool, begin by opening the PDF from which you want to extract pages, and then select the Tools tab. Next, select Organize Pages in the Tool Center, followed by Extract in the Organize Pages toolbar. Now, select the page or pages you want to extract. You can do so by typing a page number or page range into the toolbar. You can also select even pages, odd pages, landscape pages, portrait pages, or all pages from the drop-down menu. Alternatively, there are several different ways to select from the page thumbnails. To select multiple pages, select the first one you want to extract, and then press and hold the Shift key as you select the last one you want to extract. To select non-consecutive pages, select the first page you want to extract, and then press and hold the Control key on a PC or Command key on a Mac as you select additional pages. Or click and drag your mouse to select multiple pages at once. PC users also have the option to select Enable Multiple Page Selection to select multiple consecutive or non-consecutive pages without using the Shift or Control key. After you've chosen your pages, select Delete Page After Extraction if you want to remove the extracted pages from the original PDF. Or select Extract Pages as Separate Files if you want to save each extracted page as an individual PDF. Don't select this option if you want the extracted pages to be saved as one PDF. Next, select the blue Extract button. Your extraction or multiple extractions if you selected Extract Pages as Separate Files should now open in a new PDF named Pages From Original File Name in a new tab or window. You can keep that file name or select the File tab and then Save As to save your new PDF under a new name following your normal saving process. The drag and drop method is faster than the extract tool method shown in the previous section. However, it offers fewer customization options. To begin, open the PDF from which you want to extract pages. Then select the Page Thumbnails button. If you don't see the Page Thumbnails button, select this small triangle down here on the left side of the screen. Next, PC users can select the Restore Down button to reduce the size of the Adobe Acrobat window, while Mac users can select the Exit Full Screen button. The goal is to reveal some of your desktop, so you may have to use your cursor to click, hold, and drag the sides of the window to a smaller size. Note that both the Windows operating system and macOS offer other resizing methods, but that's beyond the scope of today's tutorial. When your desktop is visible, select the pages you want to extract from the Page Thumbnails pane. Once again, to select multiple pages, you can select the first one you want to extract, and then press and hold the Shift key as you select the last one you want to extract. Or select non-consecutive pages by selecting the first page you want to extract, and then press and hold the Control key on a PC or Command key on a Mac as you select additional pages. You can also click and drag your mouse to select multiple pages at once. Once you've made your selection, drag it to your desktop or other accessible locations. You can then right-click, or Mac users can control-click, the extraction and select Rename from the shortcut menu. You can then continue to rename the new PDF as you normally would. I have created many other videos about Adobe Acrobat, including how to combine files into one PDF in Adobe Acrobat, and how to create a PDF portfolio in Adobe Acrobat. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Adobe Acrobat, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, along with all my other step-by-step document software tutorials and writing tips for the real world. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic about Adobe Acrobat or Microsoft Word that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.